The drought of the 1930s, it's not great for people, and certainly not great for crops, but it's really great for grasshoppers.
And they covered the ground, and they covered the prairie, and they just ate the grass down to nothing, and wherever you walked and wherever you stepped, you were crunching on grasshoppers.
Sometimes the posts would be just covered solid with grasshoppers.
They'll eat your crops, they'll eat the clothes hanging on your clothesline, they'll try to eat your fence posts. So if you've, you know, managed to grow something, well, here come the grasshoppers to eat it.
And I remember they came out with trucks and they were just spraying to kill this large quantity of grasshoppers that came across.
The rabbits and grasshoppers, they're native to this area. They've always been in this part of the state.
Jackrabbits and cottontails, and we would go hunting. My mother was the best cook of jackrabbit in the world.
Following the wet years, when they had a lot of population, the dry years, there wasn't enough vegetation for them to eat. That's when there was more competition, and that's when the impact of those populations on crops and other things was more severe, because they were going away from their native areas and eating the crops.
And the amazing thing about it now is you go out there and there are none. Sometimes I'll just run out there myself in the evening, and my son, whenever he comes, he likes to go hunting, and I told him, well, you won't find a rabbit out there because they're gone. And I guess they realized that they were going to starve also. And if they didn't starve, they wouldn't have anything to drink. So the rabbits moved on.